more than just a trend. Sports shoes have long been an everyday fashion item. Every year, 6 to 7 billion pairs of sneakers are produced worldwide. The problem is that the shoes are mostly made from fossil-based plastics, and one pair alone causes 13.6 kilograms of CO2 emissions. A team of Spanish researchers, scientists, and medical experts wants to change this. They aim to develop a revolutionary sole and change the fashionable shoes into a sustainable, environmentally friendly product. How is this supposed to work? To find out, we set off for Zaragoza, the capital city of the Spanish province of Aragon. This is where the Aitiip Technology Centre is based, and where Marta Redrado and Raquel Navarro work. The new sole will be created in this special laboratory, where the two women work with 3D printing and different materials, such as hemp and other natural fibres, or bio-based plastics that have been processed to TPU, thermoplastic polyurethane.
In our case, we are using bio-based TPU. We needed a material that had to be a little bit flexible for, you know, like you don't want to walk on a brick. So we tested different types of materials.
The development of the new sole material is part of the European research project INN-PRESSME. 3D printing specialist and engineer Raquel has also developed her own printer for this task.
This is the INN-PRESSME 3D printer. We have done a lot of modifications, for example, in the extruder. We also changed the motor and the extruding gears to have more extruding ratio. And we also changed the filament diameter that you can put into the 3D printer from 3 millimeters to 1.75 millimeters.
80 kilometers further north, at the edge of the Pyrenees, lies the town of Huesca. Here, the Podoactiva Medical Innovation Centre is already producing custom 3D-printed orthopaedic insoles. The Podoactiva team, led by Marina Azpiroz and Ignacio Colón, is currently preparing to produce the INN-PRESSME prototype. This combines an outer shoe sole and a personalised insole. Dr. Antonio Gomez is available as a model, or rather, his feet are. They're measured using the same procedures as for orthopedic insoles.
Collecting the geometry through this technology patented by Podoactiva is the most important point. As with this 3D mold, we managed to design the plantar correction of the Podoactiva insole, which is what we will then include in the midsole that is manufactured for the shoe of the INN-PRESSME project.
For the company's co-founder, podiatrist Javier Alfaro, the INN-PRESSME prototype's development is a milestone in shoe research.
Because it seems like a perfect project for Podoactiva. The moment that we see that we can unify all our knowledge of the footprint, thousands of patients analyzed, thousands of problems solved, and be able to apply it to a sole, it was perfect. And Podoactiva also has high sustainability values. Thinking of a sustainable product such as hemp, customized Industry 4.0 was like something perfect for Podoactiva.
Marina and Ignacio have now digitally processed the foot measurement data and designed 3D models of the new prototype. This is one of the most important steps before the sole is printed.
At the end of the day, when we started, it was also new that we had to meet the expectations that it should be functional, that it should be aesthetic, and that it should be a presentable product. So to unite the two sides that need to be united for the project, I think that was the most interesting and the most challenging thing that we had to fight and develop.
Back in Zaragoza, after analyzing the 3D model from Huesca, researchers Marta and Raquel prepare to print the new prototype sole. The first tests presented some major challenges.
The 3D printing time of the shoe soles was like 22 hours, more or less. If the size of the shoe was like a 39, it takes like 18 hours, but the 45 took like 24 hours. So it's a whole day. You have to check if the 3D printer is printing, that everything is okay, if the temperature is the right one.
For greater efficiency, the materials and technology must be perfectly harmonized.
It's very important that they are homogeneous, so the process of the 3D printing goes smooth and it doesn't clog the nozzle. Before going into printing a full-size shoe, what we do always with all the materials that we test is to 3D print some samples, like these dog bones and these rectangles, which we use for mechanical characterization to see what are the properties of the 3D printed material and to see if it meets the requirements that they are needed.
Raquel and Marta prepare the printer and start the process. Now it's time to wait and see. Line by line, layer by layer, over the next few hours, the in-press-me sole is created.
I think we are not that far away because these shoes are already offered by an industrial partner. But I think the main challenge here, we have the material, we have the machines, they need to match.
Next day in Huesca, the entire research team wants to find out how the new prototype fits. The customized sole has been joined to the upper, and Dr. Antonio Gomez, clinical research director at Podoactiva, tests his shoe for the first time.
Here we're talking about personalization, which is really the value that we bring. Also that it's functional, that it's even therapeutic, that it can help people and contribute to the world of health. So it's a product that not only has aesthetic value and everything that's fashionable, but it's also functional.
Digital analysis of data from sensors in the sole brings the details to light.
It looks good, because the truth is that with the insole I don't notice that I have a little bit more lateral instability. But as the 3D printing has been integrated in the sole, it has improved the external support. The pressure peaks have also gone down a lot. We have more load distribution surface and that's great. And then, well, the peak pressure has also gone down a little bit and they feel very, very comfortable.
It's a result that, after more than 3 years of research and development, is also extremely promising from an industry perspective.
I think it's a product that fits Podoactiva 100%. We will see the entry routes for this product, the clinics. Obviously, that's our entry route and it's going to be easy, but possibly also in the shoe shops. We will have to see how we can personalize these shoes.
The sneaker of the future, made from environmentally friendly biomaterial and natural fibers, and completely customized using 3D printing.